Hello guys! Today I will show the roadmap to become a successful Java web developer in 2021. I will show the most requested technologies in 2021 to learn, from school to a software architect. I will just ask you to subscribe to my channel and let's go! I've started coding very late, at 18 years old, in university. I haven't even studied computer science, I studied electronics. But I had multiple programming topics, more low level with C and C++, but of course I had Java to learn some high level too. What I've learned at school, which was very helpful, was two or three different languages to know their different usages, but also to know that I can easily switch from one to the other when I will be more comfortable. An IDE, Eclipse, NetBeans or IntelliJ, I learned that they are powerful tools that help me every day to work with programming languages. And finally, some basic operations with variables, and some interactions with the database and the network. In my opinion, the main topics to learn at school are to be familiar with the IDE and the programming language. Learn how to build basic algorithms, to train the brain to think as a programmer. In plain Java, what must be known is some basic concepts, like difference between abstract classes and interfaces, and how to use them, be comfortable with the loops, and be comfortable with the Boolean conditions. This is the minimum to start asking for an internship somewhere. I've been almost one full year working as an intern, learning from other developers. At the end of the year, I was ready to look for a real job. But what are the skills required nowadays, in 2021, to start asking for a real job? The object-oriented programming concepts, the difference between static and class methods, arguments by value or by reference, how to implement much more complicated operations, with streams, lists, optional, and lambdas. To be comfortable working in a team, reading the code from others, and the most important, writing code to be easy to read by others. Starting to learn the main frameworks used, like Spring and Spring Boot. Know how to use a dependency management tool like Maven or Gradle. And one big important point, the unit tests, how to write simple unit tests and how to run them. This is also the moment to learn how to use other tools not directly related to Java. The basic usage of a version control system like Git, how to use a database with simple queries and filters, and to be aware about the main concepts of the web requests, the HTTP methods, the body, the query strings, and the headers. Those are the skills that must be built within the first 2 to 3 years being a Java web developer. I've been working for 4 years in my first job, 4 years learning these concepts, these tools. Then I chose to go to a bigger company, with a bigger developer team, where I could grow faster. At this stage, being a mid-experienced developer, the actual knowledge required are how to implement much more complicated design patterns, singleton, facade, some complicated search algorithms, the usage of different types of lists, maps, and sets, handling with dates, string formattings, or even regexes, the RESTful concept, the separation between the frontend and the backend, when a feature fits best in the frontend or in the backend, more advanced unit tests and integration tests with mocks and TDD, and some developers' mindset, like the Keys Principle, Solid, Yagni, or Dry. Now, the frameworks and libraries are a must-know. How to configure Spring GPA, Spring MVC or Spring Boot, some basics about the security, the authentication, and the useful libraries like JSON, Guava, XML parsing or logging. And continue to develop the DevOps skills. How to perform more complicated operations in a database, with joins, aggregation operations, indexings. Having played a little bit with a NoSQL database like MongoDB, DynamoDB, Redis, having played with some bash scripts, know how to perform some basic operations in a Unix machine, know how to use the CI/CD pipeline when it's triggered, the operations that are performed, how to trigger a pipeline or how to break a pipeline. At the end of my mid-level, I started to manage some people, some interns, coach them, guide them, teach them what I've learned and what they must learn. And after 7 years working as a developer, I applied for a senior developer position. At this stage, the important thing is to know how a complete application works with all its components. The required skills of Java and the frameworks are advanced security methods, authentication types, HTTPS, password management, OWASP, JVM tuning and optimization, the garbage collector, advanced design patterns for complete architectures, CQRS, event sourcing, SOA, microservices, to be able to perform performance benchmarks on different technical solutions, to be able to investigate different frameworks to know if they will match with the needs of the project, and advanced test suites as the load tests. And now, the application boundary goes larger. Your knowledge must embark a larger scope of the application. Docker, the cache management at all the levels, server, database, browser, CDN, some more advanced frontend problems as different types of compilations, the deployments, the frontend from mobile, the usage of the backend from a mobile application, some knowledge about networking, about the web servers, Apache or Nginx, and of course the cloud computing, AWS, GCP or Azure. With all of this comes the management of a team, listen to people of the team, help them grow. At this step, I've started learning some other languages, such as Python or Kotlin. It's interesting to know how a problem can be solved in different languages. It's interesting to learn which language is more appropriate for each case. This is more or less the roadmap I followed and the requirements I'm asking when I interview some people to work for me. The technologies may change. It will depend on the one used by the company you are applying to. But these are the most used and most requested technologies for a Java web developer in 2021. If you think I've missed an important point, leave a comment. And I will appreciate if you subscribe to my channel, where you can find some useful content to learn about the technologies I showed before, with real examples, as done in the companies. If you like it, don't forget the thumbs up, and see you soon. Bye!